Good morning. Welcome to Children's Ministry at the Fort Bend Church. I'm Miss Deirdre. It's prayer time. Let us pray. Dear God, please hear our prayer. We praise your holy name. We thank you for your love. We thank you, God, for Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the Bible and our church. We thank you for our pastor and our parents. We thank you for our teachers and our friends. We love you, God, our Father. Dear God, help us to obey you and make you smile. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, let's stand and sing. This is the day. Do you know that people can show they love God in all sorts of ways? Families can pray, sing songs, or even help other people because they love God. That's how they worship Him. Your family brought you to church to worship Him, or they opened this video so you can watch it. Before Joshua died, he gathered the people together and reminded them of some things that God wanted them to know. Joshua told the people that God wanted them to love, worship, and obey Him. God is so good to us. God gave you a family that loves you and a place to live. He gives us puppies and pizza. He gives us friends, the Bible, and His Son, Jesus. It's good to remember the things God has done for us. Joshua wanted God's people to remember all the things God did for them. The Bible is the place where we will read some of the things that Joshua wanted the people to remember. These things are written down in the Old Testament book of Joshua, which is close to the beginning of the Bible. Let's watch the Bible story, Joshua challenged the people from Joshua chapters 23 through 34.
Hi friends, it's me, Megan, and I'm Jessie. Hey Megan, do you remember that time we went horseback riding and you let me ride on your horse with you so I wouldn't be scared?
Oh, I do remember that. We had so much fun and you did great.
Yeah, we did have fun. So, do you remember that time you sprayed sunblock on me so I wouldn't get sunburned?
Oh yeah, I do. I think you were able to play outside all day without getting burned.
Yep. And do you remember that time I was sad I didn't get to go ice skating and you made me feel better?
I do. Jessie, you are so sweet to remember all these things.
Aw, thanks. You're my good friend, Megan.
Aw, we are good friends, Jessie. You remembering things I've done for you reminds me of our Bible story.
It does?
Yeah. In today's Bible story, Joshua told the Israelites to remember what God had done for them and how God kept every promise he made to them. Let me tell you the story, friend. Joshua was getting old. For many years, God had given the people of Israel peace and rest from their enemies. They had not fought any battles. One day, Joshua gathered all of the Israelites. He had some important things to tell them. Joshua said, "Remember what God has done for you. When you were in battle, God fought for you. I want you to be strong. Do everything God told you to do. Do not disobey God, and do not turn away from God. Trust him." Joshua said, "God has never broken a promise to you." Then Joshua reminded the people of everything God had done for them in the past. God had called Abraham and given him a son, Isaac. God had given Isaac two sons, Jacob and Esau. God had rescued the Israelites from the Egyptians. God had done so many great things for his people. Joshua said to the people, "Will you worship God or false gods? As for me and my family, we will worship the Lord." The people replied, "We will not worship other gods. We know how much God has done for us, and we love him." The people remembered that God had helped them win battles against their enemies. They remembered how he protected them as they traveled. Joshua gave the people a warning. If you do turn away from God to worship other gods, God will turn against you. He will destroy you. The people said again, "We will worship the Lord." On that day, Joshua made an agreement with the people. He set up a large stone under an oak tree and said, "When you see this stone, remember that you promised to worship the Lord. God always keeps his promises." Then Joshua sent the people back to their homes. Before Joshua died, he left the Israelites with a task: obey God. After Jesus' death and resurrection, Jesus appeared to his disciples and left them with a task: obey him by telling others about him.
Our Christ connection tells us that before Joshua died, he left the Israelites with a task: obey God. After Jesus' death and resurrection, Jesus appeared to his disciples and left them with a task: obey him by telling others about him. All right, let's review. What do you do when you need to remember something very important? Do you say it over and over again? Some people make songs to remember important things, like we remember Bible verses with our key passage song. Some people write down what they need to remember. Well, in our Bible story today, Joshua wanted the people to remember something very important. Joshua reminded the Israelites about all of the good things God did for his people. God brought them out of Egypt, took care of them in the desert, and even kept a promise that he made to them. Joshua reminded them that God is good and that they can trust God. Then Joshua warned the people not to turn away from God and worship the statues in the promised land. So, what did the people say? We will worship God. Sometimes we say we want to worship God, but we sometimes want to do what makes us happy even when we know it's wrong. The Israelites had the same problem. Joshua warned them that if they turned away from God to worship statues and idols, God would not protect them. The people said, "We will worship God." Say it with me again. We will worship God. Joshua did not want the people to forget their promise, so he put a large stone under an oak tree. When the people would see the stone, they will remember their promise to worship God. The people promised what? Let's say it again. We will worship God. Very good. Then Joshua sent them home. After Jesus died on the cross and came back to life, Jesus gave his disciples a task too. Obey him by telling others about him. Now I want you to repeat the key passage after me. You are the God who works wonders. You revealed your strengths among the peoples. Psalm chapter 77, verse 14. God does work wonders, doesn't he? Yes! Joshua wanted the people to remember that. So he gathered them together and reminded them that God fought for them and that he can be trusted. Joshua told the people to obey God. Later, after Jesus rose from the grave, Jesus also told his disciples to obey God and to tell others about him. Let's sing our key passage song, You Are, which is Psalm 77, verse 14. Then we're going to sing our worship song.
Thank you.
It is so much fun singing the key passage song. I hope you sing it this week, because it's a great way to remember our key passage, just like Joshua did with the people of Israel. Joshua set up a large stone under an oak tree to help the people remember their promise to obey God and worship only Him. Joshua wanted the people to remember the miracles God did to help them. Our big picture question asks, what is a miracle? And you remember the answer. The answer says a miracle is something God does that usually cannot be done. God's best miracle happened through Jesus' death and resurrection when God made a way to rescue sinners from sin and death. Later, for our missions moment, we will see how the Worthy family loves to plan parties in their community for their friends. These parties are called outreach events. An outreach event is a way to reach out to people outside of your church to provide a place for making friends and hopefully to tell them about Jesus. Now, let's close in prayer. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for doing wonderful things for your people. Please help us to always worship and obey you. Help us do what Jesus told his disciples to do, to obey God by telling others about you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. This week, I want you to pray for the Worthies as they think of new and fun ways to reach out to their friends. Remember to subscribe to the Fort Bend Church YouTube channel, like and share this week's video. Now, watch the Missions Moment video and think about what you would most look forward to if you were invited to the Worthies party, the games or the food. Then work on your activity page with your parent. Have a wonderful week. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Today is an exciting day. We are getting ready for a big outreach event. We are stuffing Easter eggs, making a cake, and getting stuff to grill out.
Easter is a great time for people to ask questions and learn more about Jesus.
We have invited a lot of families we know to a big Easter egg hunt and a picnic in the mountains. Our hope is, as our friendships grow with these Italian families, they will ask about Jesus and how he has changed our lives.
I'm a bit competitive. I love playing games with my friends and competing with my parents. Eating hot dogs, it's so much fun.
Ma perché un dado?
Appunto.
Perché ha giocato la sua vita. Perché i soldati.
Before the egg hunt, I'm going to tell them the story about Easter using resurrection eggs. These eggs help tell the story of how Jesus died for our sins and rose again. Lots of these kids have not heard this before, of how all their past and future mistakes can be forgiven if they believe in Jesus. Easter's all about a new birth, a new beginning. We all sin, but Jesus' love makes us new again. We do events like this 4 times a year. It gives us an opportunity to connect with the adults, and it's a lot of fun. There's so many wonderful things about living here. One of them is how nobody is in a hurry, and goodbyes can take up to 30 minutes. Relationships and spending time together are very important and a part of the culture here, which I love. Today we are in a city, not too far from ours, where we are planting a new church. We bring volunteer teams here to help us plant the church and help us build new relationships and new friends.
This is a friend of ours, Patricia, who recently accepted Jesus into her heart and got baptized. She's a big part of the new church plant. She is so nice. The church here is just getting started. Our hope is that this church will spread and there will be many churches in this area. Please pray for our new church plant and that these people will know that Jesus loves them.